This video is about the software we own and that's available to use in our fablab. For the video about the machine itself, the link is in the description. This software is called Premier+2. It's licensed by PFAFF, but it can be used to design embroideries executable by almost all the embroidery machines of the world. Its structure presents a main interface and many modules that can be launched from their respective icons, located in the bottom left of the screen. We'll see some of them in this tutorial. First of all, you need to set your hoop. It can be done from this small icon or from this button in the Home tab. Our machine is a Brother VR, but we don't have all the hoops for this model. You can find the list of hoops available under My Hoops. The embroidery needs to stay within the squared area, or in the end, the software won't process the design for the machine. The main module allows to create embroidery files from scratch. On the top part of the screen, you can find several tabs. The second tab allows you to execute complex projects step by step, but it's intended for situations in which the machine is not in a shared environment like FabLab. The third tab is for creating patterns. The fourth tab is meant to create neat writings. You can select a font from a wide range of available fonts, then write your text. Decide the typographical settings, then click on the Apply button and the text is inserted in the project. Then you can edit its position, proportions and inclination, but only as a block. Some settings are editable, selecting the text and right-clicking it to show the contextual menu. But as a general rule, the main module doesn't allow much freedom about modifying the embroidery elements. The fifth tab works in a similar way. You select a complex embroidery from a list. Adapt the settings and the dimensions, then click here to apply it to your project. The sixth tab allows you to create borders around the previously selected element. The View tab presents the viewing options and an advanced background creation button. The other tabs are for complex procedures or finally editing elements of the project, and we'll leave them for expert users to explore. To select an element, left-click. To show the contextual menu, right-click on the selected item. To cut, Ctrl-X. Copy, Ctrl-C. Paste, Ctrl-V. If you paste many elements together, a group will be created automatically. To group elements, Ctrl-G. To ungroup, Ctrl-Shift-G, or the respective buttons in the Home tab. The mouse wheel scrolls the screen vertically, Alt scroll scrolls horizontally, Ctrl scroll zooms in and out, the slider is in the bottom right corner. To undo, Ctrl Z, to redo, Ctrl Y. If the keyboard has the wrong layout, Windows key and space until the right one is selected in the small window on the right. If you're not happy with the fonts already present in the Writing tab, you can always process a new one within the software itself. The module for doing so is in the green cross icon in the bottom left corner of the screen, and we'll be glad to assist you through the process. If you save an embroidery project while in the main software, you will create a VP4 file that, when reopened in a second moment, is even more difficult to edit. If you export a project from the main software with File, export, or with the quick icon here in the top left corner, you will create a PES file that the machine will be able to see and read to create embroidery. The settings that pop up are already correct for our machine. If you need to change them, do let us know. On the right side of the screen, you will find a list of the threads used for the project. Above, there's the number of stitches and the final dimensions. Clicking this button in the Home tab will open a dedicated window simulating the final result in a three-dimensional way. Click and drag to rotate, scroll, or use the navigator squares to pan, move, and zoom. Now let's take a look at the Create module. It has a red flower icon, and it has two main differences compared to the main software. It offers a path to transform an image into an embroidery and allows for way more creative customization of the elements within the project. On clicking its icon, a wizard window appears to help us process our image. Let's see an overview of the options before looking at the structure of the module. Choosing to start from a clean slate, we can see that the tabs are different from the main module. Nonetheless, we find again some elements we already got to know: the hoop size options buttons, the 3D preview, and the right side list for the thread colors. The keyboard and mouse shortcuts are the same as for the main module. The view tab is also identical, save for a couple advanced operations missing and the option to hide the left list. We can find again the super design options within the Home tab, with less options to set before inserting the elements. The same goes for the writing options, the main difference being that here the letters need to be inserted one at a time and then spaced manually. We advise using the keyboard arrows so the horizontal alignment won't be lost. The left list can be used to select elements even within groups, but we'll see it better later. In the Home tab, it's also possible to switch the mouse function from selection to point editing with the commands in this group. To change a corner from round to angle, press Ctrl while clicking or dragging the point. To make an angle corner a round one, click it or move it without pressing Ctrl. In this module, on the left of the screen, there is a second list. Here will appear the embroidery actions in the order they are created after the last one selected. It's the same order they will be carried on as a general rule. Left click to select an item, right click to show its contextual menu. keeping shift pressed while left clicking different elements, we'll select all the ones in between, them included. To select non-consecutive items, keep pressed Ctrl. From the contextual menu for embroidery actions, one very important option is the Properties pop-up window. In the left list, there are special elements that can appear automatically or be inserted manually. Color change, its properties pop-up window allows to set the thread options with which the steps after this element in the list will be carried on, mainly color hue and minor adjustments. Stop. When embroidering, the machine will stop at this point in the list of actions and wait a manual action to continue. These two can be found also in the right-click menu. Then there are single stitch and alignment stitch that will be useful to advanced users. All these four special actions can be found in the tab Freehand Create and Precise Create, color change also in Quick Create. Below the list, there are a couple buttons for moving selected items, other than by dragging them manually. The options to show or hide the elements within a group. And an advanced selection mode option. The Freehand Create tab gives the option to draw freehand lines or areas with the properties selected beforehand. It might be useful to test the different kind of stitches in person. Now we can follow the wizard to create an embroidery from a raster image, JPG or JPEG or PNG, and see in more detail the Home and Edit tabs. And then apply the wizard to a vector image, EPS, and look at the other two create tabs.